Good morning.
Good morning.
Okay, this is Teacher Gal. All right. So can you please tell me your name?
My name is Lindsay. My English name is Daisy.
Again?
Daisy.
Daisy, that's a flower.
Yeah.
Is that your, you're the one who picked that name for you? Or
no,
it's your...
my dad.
Your dad.
Yeah.
All right. And how old is Daisy? How young is Daisy?
13 years old.
Very young. And in Korea, you are?
I'm 15.
15. Why? But I think it's like 1 year added, right?
Yeah, but I didn't pass my birthday, so...
Oh,
yeah.
Okay. I see. That's interesting. Alright, so... are you now in high school?
No, I'm in high school.
In your middle school. And how's your middle school?
How
was the school before summer vacation?
And I am going to ISM, and because it was my first, almost first year in international school,
okay.
And it was very new experiment I had, and also the education style and the schedule. It was very different with the Korean. The Korean school I was used to go, and also there was a lot of assignment assessments, and it was also hard for me to make the new friends in ISM.
But do you have now your friends?
Yeah.
Is it like very interesting if you have lots of friends, but they are in different countries? How do you feel about that?
Sometimes, yeah, it is very fun and also interesting, but that even if it is the one question, for example, in social studies, there's so many points of views that other students can answer. And for example, when I was learning about like the genocide and also the war, and some Korean students like me were also mentioning about the Korean war and also other countries. Other students from other countries were like talking about their war, and so it was very interesting.
Very interesting. Okay. Do you feel scared at first when you meet other nationalities?
Yeah.
But I know you're not pretty confident. Not that? Not that much? Alright, so.
Yeah.
As more, okay. Alright, so let's have these questions. As a student, what do you think are your rights as a citizen? Or just a student? What are your rights being a student?
The right to be educated.
Okay, very good.
Also, the right to go to school. And also, we have to respect the teachers, and also the teachers should respect us. And I think that's a very simple thing, but we have to.
Okay, very good. That's a very good answer. And when you are educated, education cannot be stolen from you, right? That's the only thing that you can cherish for a lifetime. Okay, let's go for the next one. Teachers should be able to hit students in school. What are your reaction for this? Is it good? Is this good? Is this bad?
I've heard of a lot of questions like this, because actually in Korea there was some schools that some teachers were hitting students because of some reasons. I think that it's not very right for the teachers to hit the students, because as you know, teachers and students are they're in the different career and also status, but they're all same. They're like human.
Alright, so if I am the student and you'll be the teacher, and I'm doing bad things, for example, how can you discipline me?
it doesn't have to be always physically, but maybe tell your mom, or if it is not helpful, then you can have like a counselor.
Okay, so it should be counseled.
Yeah.
You can call the attention of the parents, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, let's go for number three. Is homelessness a problem in your society? In Korea, do you see homeless? Homeless people?
Sometimes, yeah.
Okay, so what do you think is the main problem or the reason why do we have this homeless people?
Maybe sometimes there can be like their own business and there can be like the accident, but I think the real reason is that we didn't care some of the social workers. We just ignored them even though there are some students like those.
So do you think the homeless ones are not really educated?
Depends.
It depends.
Yeah, I think the answer cannot be yes.
And how about their families? Do you think there are problems with their families or with their families? Osmo mobile tripod is highly recommended. So those are the contributing factors. Okay, if we can consider, okay, why do we have homeless? But in any event, it's a good point. It all depends. All right, so let's go for question number four. What are the effects of poverty, and how can we stop poverty?
So the effect of the poverty is that some people who are in poverty, they are kind of doing some illegal jobs.
Mm-hmm.
Also, they are doing something they're not supposed to do, and it can hurt themselves individually, but also like globally. Because worldwide, there's some rules or laws the country make of their own. But if there's so many poverties, and it is true that country cannot grow or proceed more.
Progress. Okay, the country cannot progress because of the poverty.
Mm-hmm.
And people or the citizens will tend to do bad things or illegal things just to survive.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So you are now here in the Philippines you've been here for 1.5 years,
yeah.
Right? And I'm asking you earlier if you know some Tagalog terms, even like the basic greetings. I don't know. All right. How about Filipino food? Have you tried it?
Not at
all. Not at
all.
All right. So, what is the difference between Korea and the Philippines? In terms of teaching, let's go to teaching part.
I mean, in Philippines, it is much more free than in Korea, because Korea it is very strict, and almost all the students are stressed, and I also experienced that, and there's too much of homeworks and also academies, extra homework.
Mm-hmm.
And in Philippines, everyone is free, and we can in school. I don't know if because I am going to the international school, but it's actually much more free, and also the teachers here, nicer, and the teachers almost all know the student's name.
Wow.
Yeah.
In Korea, you call by your name or by your surname?
By name, but there's some name card in here.
Oh,
the
okay. So the
yeah.
teacher will recognize you. But here in the Philippines, you don't have to have tag name
yeah.
or the name plate just to be recognized. All right, so that's a good thing. Okay, so that's the end of our interview. You did good. You're very confident. I am. And do you have any questions, by the way? None. Okay, so goodbye. All right.